Northeastern going back to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1990.
Northeastern is returning to the CAA championship game.
What a win for Northeastern, 63-56 over Georgetown.
The Northeastern comes to East Lansing and topples mighty Michigan State.
Between the legs dribble, 1 second left. Fadeaway shot, it's good at the buzzer!
A legend in the basketball community, Bill Cohen has elevated Northeastern basketball to heights not seen since the days of Jim Calhoun and Reggie Lewis. Coach Cohen has made a major impact on and off the floor due to his commitment to his players and genuine care for everyone associated with the program.
Well, I've known Coach Cohen for, a good 15 years or so, and was well aware that the Northeastern had struck gold by getting him as a coach. He gets the most out of his talent. Northeastern's been very fortunate to have Bill Cohen, and not to mention the coaching aspect, but the word gentleman certainly applies. He's a fantastic representative for the school.
For those of you who know Coach Cohen, he'll deflect any personal fame or accolade. That's just his nature. Bill is one of those rare coaches that really wants to make it about the student athletes and their experiences and gives credit to everyone. That longevity, that track record of success is something to be proud of, and I hope he relishes it.
I love the attention it gets because I feel like he deserves so much more, and he's an extremely humble guy. McDonald and I, we've been here since day one, and just watching his progress, what he's turned his program into is nothing short of amazing.
Myself and Manny Adako, being a part of Coach Cohen's first class, we're connected to guys that are, our incoming freshmen this year, came in 15 years later, and former players that we played with are still connected with our current players today. The word family, fits really well with this group because that's what it is. I mean, we have 15 years worth of players that are all coming together, all pulling for each other, are all connected, will come back and get together in the summer. I think what Coach Cohen's been able to build here is pretty amazing.
Here's Stilka, and he slams it down, and one!
First and foremost, I don't think much was expected from them going into the season. I think we were picked seventh in the preseason. We had a very young team, didn't have any seniors on the roster, and we really challenged them in our non-conference schedule, playing some of the very best teams in the country, the likes of North Carolina and Syracuse and West Virginia. Through those experiences in the non-conference kind of forged really strong bonds together. They had great chemistry, and they came out of the box committed when we hit the CAA portion of our schedule and really played at a high level.
It was a crazy year. You never really knew what to expect between the shutdowns, starting back up. We had the non-contact practices, a lot of individual workouts kind of working back into things. It was difficult to get into a rhythm, but I give our guys a lot of credit. And what was a very difficult year. They were very resilient, extremely hardworking, and despite having a lot of reasons to complain, they never really did. They never really took the bait. They always kind of fought through. They stayed focused at the task at hand, and I think that's why they were able to have the success that they were on the court. No matter how many shutdowns we had, how many times guys had to go into quarantine, coming out of quarantine, starting back up again, they were always searching out ways to get better despite the situation that they were in. And I think as a coach, that's all you can really ask for from your group of players.
There were so many things that went wrong. You had so many reasons to, make excuses. But guys, just throughout the year, they just remained resilient. They were vigilant. The way they came out wanting to give their all, it was beautiful, in my opinion.
63-47 final, end of the year for William & Mary. And things keep on rolling for Bill Cohen and Northeastern at the Colonial Tournament. And congratulations, Mac, to the coach. He's the all-time wins leader in Northeastern history, 251, surpassing Jim Calhoun.
I think it probably meant a lot more to us than it did to him. We obviously knew what that number was. We were well aware of it. I think it just goes to show not only how great of a coach Coach Cohen is, but also how great of a person he is. That you can see the joy in his players' faces when he walked into that locker room and they showered him with the water bottles. I think that's really, kind of what it's all about. And just very grateful to be a part of it.
It was great just seeing how happy everyone was for Coach. And, it was well-deserved. You're just extremely, extremely excited for Coach. And especially, he doesn't want credit for things like that. And I think once it happened, just all the love and text messages he received and trying to congratulate Coach, I think it speaks on just the type of bonds he's built with people around his program since he's been here.
No, you know, it's all about the journey. You know, I think if you're looking at, you know, breaking it, that's a destination. And, you know, although we're extremely proud of everything we've accomplished over the last 15 years, it feels like we're just getting started. We're already getting ready in preparation for next year and what that team's going to look like and how we're going to do it. And I think that's the fun of coaching. You know, if you're ever satisfied with what you did yesterday, you haven't really done much today. And you have to keep staying on that journey and believing in yourself, believing in your staff, believing in your student athletes, and see what magic you can create. But I'm extremely grateful for all the guys that have come and worn a Northeastern uniform, gone out there and contributed, and just to be a part of this great university for 15 years, I'm honored, humbled, and grateful.